welcome to a windswept Leicester Square for the premiere of Sucker Punch. I'm here for Hey You Guys, and we're going to hopefully, fingers crossed, if we manage to grab them, be talking to the stars of the show later today, along with Zack Snyder, and if we're very, very lucky, a few other people, maybe just possibly new Superman Henry Cavill. Play this crazy action heroine, basically, in Sucker Punch. How was that? It's a bit of a departure from your previous stuff.
It was unbelievable. I mean, you know, the physical training was something that I've never done before, and it was so empowering and cool and so much fun, and it was a massive challenge, but I had the best time I've ever had working on a film.
And obviously Baby Doll, she does a bit of a dancing in the film. We never actually see it. Was that a little bit gutting? You read the script, you think, oh,
I think it was best that we didn't see it, you know, because the idea is that her dance is so mesmerizing that, you know, it distracts these people while they're stealing objects from them. I don't know if anybody could be that mesmerizing in real life. I certainly couldn't, so I think it's better that we've left it to everybody's imagination.
And you're also on the soundtrack as well.
Yeah, indeed.
So, we will be seeing you in sort of more action-y roles in the future, perhaps a comic book role, perhaps with Zack, maybe?
If Zack Snyder directs it, I will do it. Yeah, pretty much.
Amber in the film. So you're obviously in, I hope it's not too much of a spoiler for our viewers, but it's obviously you're playing a pilot for a lot of the film and sort of out of the action. Did you get a little jealous of the other girls not getting to?
You know, it was fun to watch them on the sidelines, all their, you know, hard work and dedication and choreography, but, you know, Amber's kind of the eye in the sky, and she was there and she had the girls back, so I really didn't feel like I missed out too much.
Okay, and I mean, how much of that, you know, the bits we saw, how much of it was sort of props or sets, or was it all
The Mecca, it was just like a green egg. It was basically just a shell. And it was, you know, on it was mechanical, so it didn't move a bit, but it was mostly green screen for me.
Thank you.
Cool, thank you.
Very different to High School Musical, huh?
Yeah, it is.
Did you enjoy kicking ass?
I really did. It was such a phenomenal experience. I mean, working with Zack, getting to use my body to throw myself into these crazy scenarios and working alongside such amazing actresses. Like, I love these girls to death.
It was so empowering women. I loved it.
Like, yay, so good. I know. I mean, we felt like warriors by the end of it.
And I'd say you got to vent a lot of anger there.
Especially with the guns. Shooting the guns is like, it really gets out all the frustration.
I'd say, and here, you got to wear some great little outfits there that you probably never get to wear. You know, your little costumes.
Yeah.
Would you know, you always get to dress up for red carpets. Did you ever think of designing?
Yes, actually. I'm in the process.
Okay. And what about an album? I keep being asked.
In the process, kind of. I mean, I did too, and I'm kind of taking a break, focusing on film. But I'm so distracted. They just keep yelling.
Yeah, I know.
Music's such a big part of my life, so I'll definitely revisit it.
I don't know how you're not deaf yet with all the screaming. Everywhere you go, people scream at you.
It's distracting. I hear my name in my head. It's like, too much.
Vanessa, thank you.
Shut up.
Hello. You're closer to the fire. You have the best spot.
It's nice and warm over here.
It is, kind of. Every 3 seconds, it's warm.
Okay, for the benefit of the people who are listening to this, you've obviously just punched a man's hand there.
I know. I should have warmed up a little bit.
You seem to be getting into that whole action heroine thing. Something we'll be seeing more?
Maybe, yeah. Hopefully. It's incredibly empowering to know that physically you can go beyond any level that I thought I could go before. It's beautiful.
Something that's very interesting, a little sort of quirk of fate at the moment in the UK. This is opening tomorrow against Jake Gyllenhaal's film. You're at Donnie Darko, former co-star. How do you feel about that?
Oh, we're going to knock him out. Absolutely. No question.
Thanks for Jake.
Thank you.
What's going on over there? Punching?
Yeah, I think you get that next, actually.
All right.
We've got you playing the villain of the piece.
Yes.
So can you give us some sort of... how do you get into character? How have you been so nasty to such pretty girls?
Mustache is number one. The thinner, the more evil.
I think, and just, you know, really going there. And the thing is, we created a real bond with everybody, a trust. So, you know, we were free to really explore those really dark.
What did you prefer, brothel keeper or mean security guard? I mean,
mean security guard. Oh, the orderly. You know, the pimp is a pretty. Apparently, pimping is easy. I had no idea.
Pimping is easier.
Nice. It's easy. Yeah.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Been a bit of a long haul to get this to the screen. Are you surprised? Pleased to see it now.
It's super awesome to see it now. You know, and always here in London, like, you know, they do an amazing job. I mean, look at that. They really pull out. There's a thing here I'm tripping on. They pull out all the stops, so it's pretty cool.
And one of the things that really struck me about this film is the title sequence. You saw the king of title sequences now, the credit sequence, yeah, where you tell the story.
Yeah.
Can you sort of, how did that come about in the first place?
We had to get Baby to the institution, but you had to know why she was going there. And I didn't want to, like, you know, do this sort of belabored, what do you call it, domestic violence scene. Sorry, it's fire. So I said, I could do this, quick and cool.
Fair enough. And very quickly, Zach, one of the things that's been in the news the last couple of days is that Warners are planning to launch a sort of Justice League thing in the same vein as Marvel have done with their comics. How does your take on Superman fit in with all of that?
It doesn't. See, the thing about, you know, it's like what Chris Nolan and what I'm doing with Superman, you know, what they'll do with Justice League will be just its own thing with its own Batman and its own Superman. And so we'll be over here with our movie, so we kind of get to do it twice, which is kind of cool.
Awesome.